This is Jagdish Parry, Assistant Professor, Department of Tripoli at Army DMTB University. So I'm here to deliver the topic under a stepper motor. So we know we have so many machines available nowadays, for example, induction motor or synchronous motor, what it may be. And also we have some special electrical machines are available for a certain precise speed control applications, for example, like a robotics or satellite or what it may be. So this stepper motor comes under a special electrical machines because it have some precious features is available. So today we'll see this special motors. So these are the outline of our presentations. First thing is stepper motors. We should know what is a stepper motor and the block diagram of a stepper motor, then construction and working of stepper, then types of stepper motor, then mode of excitation. So how we can operate a stepper motor, and the drive circuits. So what are the drive circuits are available for controlling a stepper motor, and characteristics of stepper, at last the closed loop control of a stepper motor. Yes, a stepper motor. So what is I mean by a stepper motor? A stepper motor is also called as a step motor, which is an electromechanical devices which convert the electrical signal into a motion of rotations, which means a shaft motion in the form of a rotations. That is the main principle of a stepper motor. The input is the electrical signal we are giving as an input, and the output is it's like a angular motion. Then it is a special type of electric motors that moves in preciously in motions, which means wherever we require a step motion, then we can go for this stepper motor. And these stepper motors are available nowadays in the range of 12, 24, 72 revolutions per step, which means it rotate in a step by step, and also the stepping angle should be at 30, 15, 5, 2.5, 2, and 1.8 degree per steps, which means this shows the degree, which means how the motor will step in the angle of degrees. So these are the major stepper motors are available nowadays, and also due to this precious control, the stepper motor is widely used in the industries, medical side, satellite, robotics, and also the control of application. So due to the precious control, this stepper motor is widely applicable in various applications we have seen. But the several features which is common to all the stepper motors, what are they is the high accuracy, which means the stepper motors gives a high accuracy one. We can control in a open loop system also, and also a reliable one, because here we are not using any brushes, so it should be in a reliable one. And then the stepper motors required a sequence and a driver circuit. These two plays the major, because of these two we can control the speed of a stepper motors very easily. The sequence controller is nothing but it's a switching circuit. It should represent how the motor will be rotate, in which direction my motor should rotate. This and all will decided by this switching circuit. And the driver circuit is required for changing the direction, actually the changing the current and the flux direction, we can go for the driver circuit. So this is the basic block diagram of a stepper motor. If you see the block diagrams, I have a sequencer, I have a driver circuit, I have my stepper motor, and I have some separate power supply to the driver circuit. So each block is doing is, let us take the sequencer. This is nothing but the switching circuit. It's mainly used to change the direction of the rotations, in what direction my motor should rotate. This and all comes under the sequencer, will control the direction of the motor. And the driver circuit will comes under the direction of the flux or a current rotations, in what directions my flux and current should be rotated. Thus that will take care about these driver circuit. And we have a stepper motors, normally we have many types of stepper motors are available nowadays, we will see by the upcoming slides. So this is the basic block diagram of a stepper motor. So we need the sequencer and the driver circuit is a major part for controlling a stepper motor. And we will see the constructional feature of a stepper motor. Let us take this is the constructional the view of a stepper motor. So we have a stator and a rotor like our induction motor. So the stator is nothing but it consists of a coil, and the rotor here which is nothing but a permanent magnet. So what is the beauty in the stepper motor is the stator is made up of magnetic coils, and the rotor is consist of a permanent magnet. It is in the form of a permanent magnet, and I have a windings which is wound in the stator coils, and I have my windings which is wound in the rotor also. So what is this working principle is the stepper motors works on the principle of electromagnetism, which means whenever I give a supply to the stator winding, my coil will get energized and it will acts like a magnet. Already I have my rotor which is in the form of a magnet. So these two will attract each other and it align in itself. That is the main working principle of stepper motor. It align itself and the same pole, which means the stator poles and the rotor should be in same line. If it is aligned in a same line, then this coil will get energized, then my motor will turn into one step. That is the basic principle. When the stators are energized, the rotor moves to align itself along with the stator. So, we'll see the working principle of a stepper motor. I already told the working principle of stepper motor is an electromagnetism. It consists of stator as well as rotor. The rotor is made up of permanent magnet and the stator is made up of electromagnets. So, if we give supply to the stator winding, there will be a magnetic field developed in the stator. Now, the rotor is made up of a permanent magnet, will try to move with the revolving magnetic field of stator. So, this is the basic principle of a stepper motor. So, this diagram shows as 8 stator pole and a 6 rotor poles diagram. If you see the diagrams, here I have 8 poles here in the stator and I have 6 poles in the rotor. So, I have stator and rotor here. So, what I am doing is here this A and A dash will show as a one pair and the B, B dash is shows another pair. Likewise, we have C and D. So, if my A and this rotor one is will get aligned in a same line, then my motor, the A coil will get energized and the motor will step into one step. So, that is the basic working principle of a stepper motor. So, what is the, if my A and A pair coils forms a one pair and a B and B also foil one pair. Likewise, if you take an 8 pole stator and a 6 pole motor, we have 4 pairs, which means A, A dash, B, B dash up to D, D dash. So, each of this coil pairs form an electromagnet and also my rotor is consist of a permanent magnet. If I give supply to the stator, what my electromagnet will say, it will get energized and it will attract with my rotor magnets. Then these two will get energized and will align in the same line, then my motor will move in a one step. That is the main working. Similarly, by energizing the coil in a sequence, we can control the motor in small steps to complete a complete rotation. So, we should concentrate on the sequence circuit, then we can move or we can rotate the motor in a very, in any precious steps like or revolutions or a degree. Now, we will see some types of stepper motors. Normally, the stepper motor is divided into 3 types. One is variable reluctance stepper motor. From this, we have a single stack variable reluctance stepper motor and a double stack. Then, we have a permanent magnet synchronous motor and at last, we have a hybrid synchronous stepper motor. So, the next is the mode of excitations, which means how and all I can operate as stepper motors is based upon the applications, because for each and every application the speed is not same. For each application the speed will be vary. So, depends upon the applications we can go for any mode of excitations. So, the different types of excitation schemes are, I have full step, in full step I have one phase on and two phase on, then I have off step, then I have microstep. So, we will see one by one what is a full step mode of excitation. So, the full step mode of excitations comes under one phase on. Let us imagine I have a 4 pole stator. Here let us say this A, that is the green color, which says that my A coil get energized now. The next step is the B coil will get energized. The next is the A dash will get energized. Next the B dash, in the sense full step, which it will moves at a full step from A to B is nothing but a full step, but one phase on, in the sense at any time one phase will be in on. This is a one type of mode of excitations we can operate a stepper motor. So, the A phase will get on here, which means the A coil will get energized, then my motor will turn, will rotate at one step. The next condition is my B phase will get energized, which means from here, let us say this is the rotor, right? The rotor is rotating from here to here, in the sense here initially the A coil will get energized, then the rotor will, these two will get energized, then motor will rotate one step. If you come to these cases, B coil will get energized, then the rotor will move from this step to this step, which means the one step here. This is called the one phase on and a full step. From A to B, this the in between gap is nothing but the full step. Likewise for C, from B to A dash it will comes in one step. Then from A dash to B it will comes to one step. So this is called the full step. Full step mode of acceleration will be like this. Let us see the operation here. I have totally four steps here. I am taking A, B, A dash and B dash. If A will energize, then remaining are all 0, then B will energize, remaining 0, then A dash remaining 0, then B dash remaining will be 0. So, this is the basic operation how my rotor will rotate under a full step mode of excitation in one phase on. So, in this cases only one phase I am turning on, remaining on all is off. So, the next thing is a two phase on, like a one phase this one also same, but at any time two phases will be in on, that is the difference between these two. So, let us take this A, B, the two phases will be in on here, next well coming to B and A dash will be turning on, then A and B, A dash and B will be turning on and B dash and A will be turning on. What is thing is, it is a full step is happening, but at a time two phases will be in on condition. That is difference between one phase on and two phase on. If you see the tableau column, I have four steps here also, but at any time, at any step, the two coil will get energized here. Initially, I have A and B will get energized, then B and A dash will get energized, then A dash and B dash here, then here A dash, sorry, B dash and A will get energized. So, this is the difference between two phase and one phase on. So, this is the way we can also control the speed of a stepper motor by this two phase on. So, the next is off step mode of excitations, in the sense of at any time only off step only it will move, like in the degree of 1.8 or 2.5 degree. This method is very essential for an accurate speed. If we need any accurate speed control, then we can go for this off step mode of excitation. The working is initially, this is a combination of one phase on and two phase on. Initially, my A coil will get energized and my coil and the rotors are aligned in the same, then it will move from one step. If you come to the next diagram here, it will move from here to here, that is represented here. In this cases, my A and B will get energized, then again this rotor will move into another off step, then it will come at a B. So, in the sense initially one phase will come here, then next another phase will come here, here only I am getting my full step. In the sense the off step is nothing but for getting the full step it requires two steps to for off step. Then again it will comes from B, in between the B and A dash, then another it will comes here. Likewise we can achieve the off step also. So, here the truth table for this. So, initially for here I have 8 kind of steps because for achieving full off steps we require 2 full steps here. So, initially I have phase A on, then remaining order will off. For next step, my A and B will on, remaining will be off. Like this, we have totally 6 steps here to achieve this off step. And this is a frequently used method to get an accurate speed control of a stepper motor for any kind of applications. So, at last we have a micro stepping mode of excitation. So, we have so many advantages by using this step, but it required a large torque. So, because of this we are not preferring this micro stepping mode of excitation much, but normally we have used the off step mode of excitation for any applications. The micro stepping is nothing but it will move by a little degree, for example 1.8 degree it will move like very slow steps, that is called the micro stepping. So, from A to B, if you want to come from A to B, it requires a minimum of 4 steps, then only it reaches the B, which means one full step. The next we will move on to the drive circuit. Drive circuit is very essential for a stepper motor to change the current and the flux directions, to change the direction of the motor. This is very essential. The drive circuit, the main function of the drive circuit used to change the current and the flux direction in the phase winding itself. So, the direction change is done by two method, one is unipolar drive, another one is bipolar drive. We will see the unipolar driver circuit. Let us say the circuit, I have my voltage supply here Vs and I have 3 phases here, phase A, phase B and phase C. For each phase windings, I am connecting one transistor here, T1, T2 and T3. For each winding, I am connecting some freewheeling diode and also the series resistor in parallel with each phase winding. Let us take phase A, phase B and phase C. Let us take this is the driver circuit for a 6 pole stator, because I have 3 windings here. So, 6 pole in the sense I have A, A dash, B, B dash and C, C dash. So, I have some base drive signal here for controlling the 3 phase windings. Let us say I am connecting some external resistance here and connecting some freewheeling resistance here. So, let us say here for the operation of these 2 modes of operation is there. One is T on and T off. During T on time what will happen and during T off time what will happen. So, we know this is the phase is nothing but it is a coil, it is a inductor, we know its the capacity is to store energy and have a freewheeling diode is for circulating the current throughout the windings. We will see one by one. During on conditions what will happen is the let us take my phase A winding is energizing now. So, what will happen is the current will flow from my phase winding and again it will go back to the supply. So, this is during on conditions. At this case my phase B and phase C should be in off conditions. So, after energizing de-energizing after the switch is turned off, which means the transistor will turn off, what will happen is due to this we have my current circulation in the circuit, but my aim is to get my current through the circuit should be in a drain now, then only I can energize the B phases again, which means I have to switch off this A phases fully, then only I can go for B. So, for this cases I am using this freewheeling diode, it will de-energize the current which is flowing in the A phases. And then this A phases will fully de-energize, which means there is no current flow in the A phases. Then again the same procedure what I am doing is I am going to energize this B phases, which means in this cases I am going to switch off this A phase and C phase, only B phase will alone turn on, which means I am turning on this transistors alone. The same process is going on here and again I want to switch off this A and B phases, then at last I want this C phases will get energized alone. The same process will happen here. So, during off cases I want to switch off these switches, then the current whatever is flowing in the circuit is send it back to the supply through these freewheeling diodes. So, this is the basic principle and the unipolar in the sense the current will flow in only one direction, that is the main thing here. The current will flow from source to voltage, that it will not come back again. So, this is the principle, this is how my switching circuit is happening from each phase windings from A to B. The next type is a bipolar drive circuit. In the name itself we can say the bipolar in the sense the current will flow in any directions from here to there and there to here. Here also the same principle, but I already told the driver circuit is essential for changing the flux and the current directions of a stepper motor. So, for this normally we required 4 switches. So, here I am using 4 transistors T1, T2, T3 and T4 and also parallelly I am connecting 4 diodes D1, D2, D3 and D4. In between I am connecting my phase windings, whether it is a A phase or B phase or C phase I am connecting. So, this whole diagram is only for single phase winding, whether it is A phase, B or C phase. So, for each phases we required 4 transistor and 4 diodes. So, here also for during on conditions what will happen is my T1 and T2 should be in on in first cases and also my D3 and D4 should be in on. In the cases what will happen is remaining 2 transistor and a diode should be in off cases. So, what will happen is during these cases my current or flux will flow, will rotate in a clockwise direction. Okay. Next cases is my T3 and T4 should be on and in this cases my T1 and T2 should be off and correspondingly my D1 and D2 should be in on, the diode D1 and D2 should be in on. In this cases what will happen is my current and flux directions will be changed and my rotor can start rotating in the opposite directions, which means anti-clockwise direction. So, this is the way how we can control the motor rotation in both the angle, whether it is working in clockwise or it is working, it is rotating in anti-clockwise, it is all depends upon the switching on and off of the particular switches, I mean the transistor and the diodes. So, this is one the main drawback of this is for each phases we required 4 switches here, which means 4 transistor and 4 diode. So, cost wise this is much more, but the efficiency wise this is a more precious speed control we can achieve by this bipolar driver circuit. So, next I have some comparative study of this bipolar and unipolar, let us take. The construction wise I have my winding with the center tap or two separate winding per phase. If I have one phase I need two separate windings, but in bipolar one winding is one windings per phase and two switches per phase is required for unipolar and four switches per phase is required for bipolar, that I already told this is the main drawback also. So, utilizing only of the available copper volume of windings, but here the motor winding is fully energized here. At last the losses of the losses will be very more in unipolar, but in bipolar the losses will be very less when compared to this unipolar. But at last we can prefer this bipolar circuit because even though the cost is more, the efficiency should be high, the speed control is very accurate one, then we can go for this bipolar drives. So, next we will see the characteristics of stepper motor. This is very important one, we should know how the stepper motor is working, how the stepper motor is controlling, how it is performing, it is all we can predict in the characteristics of stepper motor. So, the characteristics of stepper motor is divided into two parts, one is static characteristics, another one is a dynamic. We know the meaning, right? The static in the sense the static part of your motor, how it is performing, and the dynamic in the sense the rotating, which means the speed and the torque of your motor, how it will be. So, these and all will predict in the static characteristics as well as the dynamic. So, under static characteristics I have two curve, one is torque angle curve of a stepper motor and torque and a determinant torque of a stepper motor. In the sense how my torque how my angle and the torque will be, that is called my torque angle curve. Let us see under zero conditions my torque will gradually increasing. Here the holding torque is nothing but the maximum torque I am achieving while operating the stepper motor, how much the maximum torque is obtaining, that is my holding torque here. So, this curve shows that if my torque increases automatically my angle at certain stage my angle will also, once it reaches the maximum torque my angle my angle theta will gradually decreases. And initially my torque will get increases, once it reaches a maximum point then my torque will get reduces and my theta will get increases, that is shows my torque angle curve. So, here the determinant torque in the sense normally I have here, if you see the graph I have two waveforms here, the one is the motor torque, normally the motor torque will be this. So, the determinant torque in the sense if it any abnormal conditions, if any faults occurs in abnormal conditions, the torque will be in a continuous way, then it is called a determinant torque here. If you see the waveforms, you can clearly understand the difference between the motor torque and the determinant torque here. So, the next is the dynamic characteristics of a stepper motor, which means the rotating part of your motor, the rotating part of the motor is we know, right? The speed and the torque. So, in this curve we can predict the speed and the torque of your motor. If you see the graph I have so many ranges here, the holding torque we already know the maximum torques developed during the operation of a stepper motor, and the maximum starting torque here and the maximum starting torque will occur here. Here I have two regions, one in pull region and pull out region. The pull region is nothing but is the safe regions to operate a stepper motor in any environment. So, this region is the safe region. So, this is nothing but this region will comes under an extra, which means the pull out torque in the sense the maximum frequency, if the frequency is exceeded then it will be normally what is the thing is we should not operate the stepper motor in this region normally. So, the safe region is pull in region. So, here we can operate in anywhere, but once it crosses we should not operate the stepper motor here, that is called this pull out region. The maximum skewing frequency is nothing but the how much frequency I am attending for one complete rotation of a speed. Then the maximum starting frequency is this is the region where the maximum frequency I can reach it. So, this is the speed torque characteristics of a stepper motor. The x axis shows is a speed and the y axis shows is a torque, which means if my speed increases automatically my torque will also increases. So, this shows the speed torque characteristics of stepper motor. So, if you see the speed will be increasing from here to here and also correspondingly my torque will also increases. So at last I have some closed loop control of stepper motor. So I already told the stepper motor, the speciality of this motor is we can control the motor in an open loop. So normally if you take any motor, if you are controlling in an open loop, the output or the efficiency is not meet our expectations, because we have so many losses, everything will occur. So for this we need some controller to control the motor. But this stepper motor is also works under a open loop conditions also. But for a accurate precious control method, we can go for the closed loop also. The closed loop in the sense I have some feedback signal that will send to the my logic sequencer. Let us take the block diagram of this. I have my logic sequencer, as I told, this is one part, a main part of a stepper motor. Then I have my driver circuit. We have seen two types of driver circuit, one is unipolar and bipolar. And here this is my stepper motor here, and have my feedback signal here, feedback. So if any error occurs in the output of the motor, that error will feedback to the logic sequencer, then in the sequence it will rectify the error and again it send it back to the power drives, then again the process will continue. The main purpose of the closed loop control is to eliminate the error, to eliminate any faults or any error occurs, then the closed loop control is very useful and essential because of this feedback. So in this I have some optical encoder, in the sense this is the speed, I can sense the speed of a stepper motor. If any error occur in the rotation of a motor, then the feedback pulse will sense the error and it send it back to the logic sequencer. The logic sequencer will sense at what time and what windings will should energize, and it should be de-energized. These things and all will carry out in the logic sequencer, and the driver circuit will accordingly, based upon the output of the logic sequencer, the power circuit will change the direction of the motor. Then again the speed will be sensed by the optical encoder, then again the any error occurs, then again it feedbacks to the same circuit, then this is a continuous process. So far we have seen the stepper motor, what is stepper motor and what is the constructions and how we can control a stepper motor. Then we have seen the characteristics and the closed loop control of stepper motor. Thank you.